Can you explain to me something that's always been a little bit confusing, which is one of the things that we learned as we were making the show, Camp Cretaceous, was that swimming reptiles of the Cretaceous and flying reptiles are not actually, like pteranodons are not actually dinosaurs. And yet, as we say, chickens somehow are. Can you explain how that works?
Okay, so I'll try and do this with in a sort of a qualitative manner without getting too deep into lingo. But essentially, we can define dinosaurs based on certain anatomical features. Okay? The features that seem to be present in all dinosaurs is a very particular construction of the hip. And then we can actually classify different groups of dinosaurs based on the different derivations of that hip structure. That particular construction of the hip, which is called a perforate acetabulum, which is one of the features that's an easy one to remember. It's the way your hip socket is designed, is not present in other relatives, other reptilian relatives of dinosaurs that lived at the time. So pterosaurs are considered the closest relatives of dinosaurs. So you're very close. Okay. Whereas we can actually track very carefully the progression from theropod dinosaurs to birds. So we know birds are a subset of dinosaurs, but because of the difference in the hip construction and some other features of the skull and limbs, the pterosaurs weren't. The other part is these swimming reptiles. They don't have that same construction either. And to make a long story short, it's possible to track the groups from which they developed, which are very, very different groups of reptiles. They lived at the same time, but they developed from different groups.